Okay, today you're going to laugh. Okay, philosophy of underwear, men's underwear. Okay, I've been trying to think, you know, I am constantly evolving, okay? And I constantly change my mind on things. I constantly, in a way, I'm one big iteration. Iteration means to go back to the drawing board and improve on. In iteration, in essence, means you learn from what you did wrong with experience, and then you go make it better the next time. So I'm in one big constant iteration, the iteration of Andy Lee Grimm. Okay, so philosophy. I'm writing a book, The Philosophy of Something, okay? And I'm going to work, I've been working through this, and I realized that as I have travel blogged and written for over, 25 years, at least 26 years, 25 years of blogging and writing and making newsletters and making missives and just making a lot of noise in my writing, I have evolved, and there's a real value to journalizing. But I will tell you that I annoy people, okay? Why do I annoy people? Well, because I talk too much, I think too much, and I constantly iterate. I'm in slicing and dicing ideas. Okay, I've lived in 114 countries, and I've done this for 26 years. I don't have a home in the United States. I'm presently living in a tent. But everybody I am near in my whole life has been annoyed by me. First thing I ever tell a woman that I'm dating is, tell me to go screw myself. And they go, why? I says, you have to protect yourself. You have to do like my mom and say, get the hell out of here. Go to the other room. Okay. But people have to say enough is enough. And to be my friend, they have to say, Andy, you wore me out. I'm tired. Because they will tell me to stop thinking so much. And I said, it doesn't annoy me. It annoys you. Okay, I'm going to talk about the philosopher. And I'm going to keep evolving on this. A philosopher is, Alan told me this, how you do anything is how you do everything. This is a very important thing. How you do anything is how you do everything. And so right now, in essence, what I'm going to talk about is underwear. And I constantly, on my biohacking channel, am slicing and dicing and learning more. So I probably spend about an hour a day for, I don't know, at least probably 15 years. I don't know when I got on the health kick. But somewhere along the line, I'm a mechanical, really intelligent mechanical person, okay? And so what happens is the body to me is just one big mechanical gadget, okay? So somewhere down the line, I started getting involved on my bio. I also have another channel called Biohacking. But how you do anything is how you do everything. So right now I'm going to tell you about what philosophy is. Philosophy is a love of wisdom. Wisdom seeks truth by binding knowledge and experience. Knowledge without experience is really not knowledge, in my opinion. It's not really knowing something. It's really just talking about something. So the binding, the coupling of knowledge and experience is the start of philosophy. A philosopher, though, seeks truth. A lover of wisdom, wisdom seeks truth by binding knowledge and experience. A philosopher seeks truth without being influenced by love, acceptance, money, or advertising. Okay, right now you can see that most of these advertisers everything's controlled by advertising. And I'm often amazed at Bill O'Reilly. I go, Bill, haven't you made enough money yet that you can lighten up a little bit on the advertising? Tom Ballou, the same thing. Jordan Peterson, the same thing. Lighten a little bit on this, grinding it into the thing, because it's not being a complete philosopher, because you are, in a way, being held responsible for what another person does. And that's not my opinion. I don't want to be held responsible for the moral turpitude of another person. Okay, but I kind of believe that a true philosopher, like there's one, well, I forget his name, but you know, a true philosopher should be supported by the, I don't know what the proper word, maybe alms of other people. I actually think it almost ought to be anonymous donations, okay? I have this Patreon channel, and I'm doing it, but I'll keep evolving on that. The Patreon thing is a way to be a supporter of me. But on the other side is, it does create a problem. It makes me feel morally responsible to that person. I guess I would rather have anonymous donations. Okay, no way to get anonymous donations that I know of right now, but I'll figure it out. I mean, I can set up a P.O. box and people can send me a certified check or just cash. Okay. I must be alone. I will say that to be a philosopher almost requires that you get rid of the influence, or somehow you become separated from the influence. Okay, but today I'm going to talk about something that I'm not Fruit of the Looms and Hanes underwear. I actually have purchased Hanes underwear, and it's an experience, right? I don't want to recommend Hanes or Fruit of the Looms. I actually had to buy Fruit of the Looms. I went to Walmart and I normally buy at Walmart because the easiest pricing is, I really consider Walmart, Costco, and all these guys sort of a, you know, what would you call it? The ninth wonder of the world, okay? The fact that I can go into a place and get highly economical and money back guarantee on Walmart is, I think, no questions, money back guarantee, okay, which is amazing. When I taught Spanish in Peru, I used to tell you, when you go to the United States, realize that there's a lot of guarantees where you get your money back, because this doesn't even exist. I have never really learned the word in Spanish for refund. Okay, but I buy things. What I want to say as a philosopher is, you should take the good and try to leave the bad, okay? And it's really tough. So the separation of the good from the bad is part of being philosophers. Okay, I need to write that down. Separate, I'm making a, okay, so why have, I'm going to, I did some research first on Hanes and then McDonald's, no, not McDonald's, Walmart doesn't have any large underwear in stock. And I need to buy my underwear 36 to 38, I guess, because I bought the small. These things are made, they're supposed to be kind of universal, right? 32, 34 doesn't fit. It makes me, I bought some and I actually threw them away because they were too small. So I bought six. They got these tagless underwear, which I don't see a benefit. I see only a benefit for the company, because I can't read the size on the underwear, my present underwear, to go buy them again. Okay, so this is the same. I did some research a little bit, and it appears that Fruit of the Looms and Hanes are exact same underwear. Okay, and it says full cut, pre-pull. I don't know. Best fit guarantee. Oh. Wonder if anybody wants to take that guarantee up. Tag-free briefs. Okay, you got boxer shorts and you got briefs. Okay, now what am I talking about? Okay, we don't want plastics, chemicals on our skin. Okay, the worst possible thing you could do in the morning is wake up, get in a hot shower, take an extremely hot shower, come out, put extremely hot water on your skin, then put shaving cream on it. You're just inserting chemicals into your skin. I highly recommend that you guys get one of these. Oh, I got one close. Get one of these Be Macho things and do this, because everything that enters your skin goes out your prostate areas, so your colon, your area. So things that come in the skin go out the thing. So I've been trying to buy cotton clothing with no dyes, Okay, so I got on the internet this morning, and I'm looking all over for 100% cotton. They hook on the word organic, but I don't think that's sort of dildo type information. But I was trying to find 100% cotton. Seems easy. 100% cotton underwear, and I get on there. They actually will sell you a pair of underwear for almost $100. Okay, I was amazed. Okay, but it came down to it is that the pros and cons of the whole thing is it appears that for the most part, Hanes underwear is 100% cotton. Now, they had some of the brands where they put the word slash polyester. Now, what is the problem with these? Okay, the problem is there's the elastic in the band, okay? And then you have dyes. It's like, so I'm very fortunate. I really pushed. I got 10 one decision a day shirts. I got like 8 of these shirts that are, for the most part, cotton. Trust me, you never want to trust anybody. I got a couple shirts where they said they were cotton. They weren't cotton. I'm pretty sure these are cotton. But on the other side is, what am I going to do? Very difficult to get 100% cotton clothing because there's always this what if, and the United States especially. I mean, they have cotton in Egypt and they have cotton in different countries, and to get 100% cotton clothing is tough. And then they got this wrinkle-free problem, right? They want wrinkle-free, which instantly adds some sort of chemicals or something or polyester to it to make it wrinkle-free. As I would understand it, in my knowledge of clothing, that if you had 100% cotton, it's going to be very wrinkly, okay? But what is the truth? Through learned knowledge and experience with Hanes underwear. So I can actually say I've used either Hanes. Now, those guys, you guys that are wearing boxer shorts or colored underwear, there's a reason why you have prostate cancer, in my opinion, okay? The reason why you have colon cancer, the reason why you have all these different types of cancers, because you got colored underwear, bleaching tint, you know, ink and dyes into your bloodstream, and it comes out your pecker, okay? Same thing applies to women. I'm just going to always talk from a man point of view because I'm a man. But what am I trying to do? I'm trying to stop permeating my body with chemicals. Anybody that lives in a city bigger than about, I don't know, 10,000 people is in danger, in my opinion, okay? Because there's countries where the bigger the city, there's not so many cars. But right now, we got a cloud of exhaust fumes going up in the air and settling on our body, okay? And it's, we need these. I was talking to a guy the other day that actually worked with the industrial pollution, okay? He was a HVAC, heating, ventilation, air conditioning person for factories and on pollution. And we truly need huge purification systems. Okay, but trying to buy cotton underwear. What is the problem here? Well, first of all, they're going to put them inside plastic, right? So you're going to get these things served up in plastic. And then they, I'm going to open these up. And then I was laughing because one time I said, if I was rich, it used to be underwear cost about $1 a pair. And I said, if I was rich, I'd buy new underwear and, you know, always wear new underwear every day of the week and throw them away. And you can kind of do this, you know, according to what you do. This has got tape on there. So they just left some, this tape glue just left on my underwear. Golly, just what I know. I want a bunch of chemicals on my underwear. Why am I talking about underwear? This is a very delicate, there's two areas right here, the armpits and the groin area. Is highly sensitive area, okay? It's where we get our rashes. It's where we get the most irritation. It's where the chemicals, in my opinion, can almost enter the body the easiest. There's a question, I don't know what, I was laughing. I'm on a a dirt road here, and I can tell you a little hint. If you're on a dirt road and there's dust coming up, or you're in anything that's polluted, you close your mouth and you breathe through the nose, because that is a filtering system. The nose is set up to filter air, the mouth isn't. Okay, but I was in Benin, Netetengu, Benin. The clay was just rolling up in the air, and I got some goggles and some a scarf, and I started breathing through my nose because I wanted to cut it. One of the nice things about the United States is we got very little actual dust area. I think in the 1800s was the first recorded death from pollution, and it was from coal dust, I think, in London, somewhere around there. But it's an interesting thing. Okay, but I'm going to read you what they say about the product, and this is what they say about Hanes. Okay, try to get rid of some of this stuff. Hanes, it says, when it's time to stock up on basic wipe briefs, Hanes has the ones you want. So they're brainwashing us, right? These soft and breathable men's wipe briefs are knit from cool comfort fabric. That's some sort of copyright thing or registered trademark there. That wicks away the moisture from your skin. Wicking is a word that's big in backpacks. Wicking means a material that basically pulls things off your skin. So in a way, we may want moisture pulled from our skin. That's a debate, right? To keep you cool and comfortable all day. So the cotton's gonna keep you cooler, okay? You'll really appreciate the Comfort Flex, another registered trademark, waistband that now fits to you. I don't know why this waistband adjusts to you, but it does. Okay, the waistband is the dangerous part, okay? Why is it dangerous? Because this has some sort of elastic or synthetic thing inside it. I will say now, when I bought these, okay, well, these underwear show that, the coloring is on the outside. The Hanes seems to be on the inside. You don't really want the color against your skin. You don't want this ink and dye to go into your skin. They kind of screwed up here on the tag. The tagless thing is on the inside. It should be on the outside. They really want you to forget what this is. Okay. They don't want you to be able to go back here and look at the size and say, oh yeah, I bought this size. It says, yeah, basically this fades really quick. The skin, what do you call it? The oils and the chemicals from the skin and everything go at this coloring right here and erases it, so you can't figure out how to buy the same size again. The tags were nice because you could be on the outside. They don't want you to irritate it. Could have been on the outside or whatever, and they could have put this on the outside so it didn't think. But didn't fade so fast. They want this to fade fast so that you can't go back there and whatever. I will tell you to stay as a biohacking trick. Like, I got size 34 George shorts, and I'm trying to buy 100% cotton shorts. But the bottom line is, if you buy bigger pants, bigger clothing, you are wanting to get fatter. You are accepting the fact that you get fatter. So people that buy bigger and bigger pants, do it. If you're a wife and you cannot buy, if you're buying your husband your clothing, or your husband is buying your clothing, or whatever, who's ever buying your clothing, don't buy bigger clothing. That is the commitment to be getting fat. Okay, anybody that buys bigger and bigger clothing just does not care. How you do anything is how you do everything. How you do anything is how you do everything. Okay, so let's go back to read it. It's tag free. The tag free is a marketing thing. Okay, the coloring, the Fruit of the Loom, of course, is marketing, and they're not going to talk about the dye. So what was I trying to do? I was getting on the internet. I was searching for dye-free. I coupled it up with the word organic, although I think organic is just a marketing term. I really don't care much about organic stuff. I think it's really, in a lot of ways, just a a very good way to make it exclusive so you pay more. And you want to have something that, you want to have a feasibly acceptable lifestyle, right? Feasible means that, you know, you can afford it, okay? I don't want to price myself right. So what happens is, the reason why we can't be completely organic, pollution-free, is because we can't afford it. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go to all white clothing so I get the least amount of dyes and on this, the tints and the colors and all that stuff. I'll go to 100% when it's possible. Okay, they talked about dyes, and one of the tricky words they did, toxic-free dyes. Well, who makes that decision that it's toxic-free? This is just crap, okay? There's just so many ways that they lie to us. Okay, so these are Fruit of the Looms, and I seem to be one of the best things. I did a lot of, I looked at a lot of, I was ready to buy some shorts, but I mean, when they went $35 for one pair of underwear, it's kind of expensive, right? I'm going to drink out of clear glass bottles. This is while I was at Walmart today, with great work, I found a glass that would hold at least 12 ounces that I could take to Walmart, to McDonald's, and I could, see what they do is they pour the coffee into a hot cup, and all this little plastic residue that's on the inside of the thing comes off into my coffee. You can't get away from this, guys. So I'm going to instantly pour it into my glass thing, and then I got to do it without them seeing, because everybody gets paranoid, right? Everybody's afraid of getting sued. Okay, so they wouldn't serve the top the other day without the top on it. I mean, I just wanted to save on plastic. Okay, back to the underwear. But the point is this, is that glass is a safe thing to drink out of. And I'm the colored glass. Why? Why do I need the colored glass? Why do I need the dyes? I need a clear glass, which is silicone. And technically, I probably could eat sand without killing myself, right? Complete with label on the bottom. Okay. So Fruit of the Loom. The elastic's the problem. You got to keep the dye away from the skin. And one of my best pictures ever was, I took a picture of a girl that pulled down her underwear, and she had Calvin Klein embedded into her skin with a Canadian flag. Oh man, that was a great picture. I really wish I would have had a camera. It was like 20 some years ago, 25 years ago, a digital camera. Okay, so these are pretty good underwear, and they're the same as a Hanes. I don't think there's a bit of difference, really. Okay, but Comfort Flex Lightweight comes in convenient six packs, so stocking up is a no-brainer. Truthfully, I believe that for traveling, you should have at least 12 pairs of underwear, because they sell them in sets of six. Why? Why do you want to have six pairs of underwear? If you don't care, how you do anything is how you do everything. So you're going to date a guy, okay, that doesn't care about his underwear. Just, come on, guys. If you don't cut your fingernails, you don't brush your teeth, you don't have good hygiene. A lot of men I'll never forget when this guy was talking about taking a shower and washing his clothes in the shower, and he had on black clothing. My mother goes, what a pig. I mean, my mother was not with me. She was quite honest. But, you know, if you're wearing dark clothing so that as a traveler, what you're saying is, I want the ability to hide my trashy existence, that I'm dirty. I wear white clothing, bright clothing, because I'm a happy person. But I want to be able to see when it's dirty. I don't have any problem with a person wearing their clothing two or three days. I have a problem with them having dirty clothing that you can't obviously see as a thing. I think we should wear our clothing 2 days, 3 days, because it saves on cleaning and water, and hot water and all this stuff. I don't want to wash my clothing inside, what do you call it? I want to do it in a wash machine And I want to have it with hot water, extremely hot water, which is why the dyes and stuff, you don't want the colors. I just bought these two Carhartt shirts, and I should have, you can buy a cream one, but the least amount of dye, I'm going to take my blue one, and I'm going to, every time I put it in the hot water, you can see the blue coming out of that. Made in Guatemala shirt. Carhartt. I'm gonna get rid of the dye touching my skin. Okay, what happens? We sweat. We start getting really hot. That dye comes, it opens up our pores. Our pores open up so that we can sweat. It's kind of a two-way street. In, out, whatever. And then the dye goes into our bloodstream. I did an experiment one time by accident that I was putting iodine on my body, and I put it on. It kept saying, this old YouTube videos kept saying that if it disappears within 5 minutes, you have an iodine shortage. So I kept putting it on, putting it on, putting it on. Next morning, I was urinating brown. I was like, went right through my body and out the thing, out the urine. This is what I did a research. There's over 100 vitamins that we can take transdermally through the skin. You can put these little little patches on your skin. They're going to be given. There's all sorts of things that go in through this thing. The size of the molecule. Just trust me. There is nothing you put on your skin that doesn't go into your bloodstream. Okay. So the clothing you have, the shorts you have, the underwear, the most delicate area of the body. Okay. So when you stock up. White Breeze. So soft, this men's underwear is made with soft and breathable cotton. Thank you. Doesn't say what percentage, right? Keep you cool. Cool, comfort, wicking, improved waistband, tag-free, because who wants scratchy tags? I want a scratchy tag on the outside so I can know what size it is, but I want it out of 100% cotton. I think it's hard to print on 100% cotton. Cold wash. Hanes recommends machine washing this men's underwear in cold water to help reduce energy usage. I recommend that you use it in extremely hot water so that you melt the plastics out of your clothing. I see, like right now, I got some tape residue on my underwear, right? That glue is poisonous. These guys, everybody that's putting all those hand creams on your body all day, you're going to die young. Okay. It says fabric 100% cotton. Whatever that means, in legal terms, that's what it means. See, 100% cotton. Now, one of the pages that I was on had the word polyester at there after it. They were playing games. I want no chemicals to go through the pores of my skin. Okay, I have learned, if you want to know, the best thing you can ever do is sweat. Okay, that is how the toxins leave your body, and it's one of the natural ways of cleaning up your lymph glands and all this crap. And the reason why you have high blood pressure is because you never sweat. Lymph glands, if you don't do a lymph gland massage, you're going to have high blood pressure. But to test, I'll do this a video pretty soon. I can do a lot of these types of things. I have one of these wristband things, and you really need to test your blood pressure almost 6 times a day for over 2 or 3 weeks, like at least a week, okay, to know what, just to get an idea. Let's see what my blood pressure is. It doesn't matter to me if it's high because... Why? Because it goes up and down. I've drank 5 cups of coffee today. Of course it's high. Oh man, it's pumping up. Scary. I read in at 120 over 88 this morning. Now I'm going to read in really high. Maybe I have white coat syndrome. White coat syndrome is when you get nervous, so your blood pressure goes up. When you run, your blood pressure goes up. These guys are putting this plastic, I think this... is this iPhone, this Apple watch that's monitoring your bloodstream? You don't want to cut off the blood to your hands all day. Okay, so I'm going to see what my blood pressure is. I'm going to be honest with you, too. These are not as accurate as the arm ones, but they're más o menos correct. Okay, the goal here is you should test your blood pressure 5 times a day, okay, until you get a reading as to the kind of the diurnal circadian rhythms of your body. And let's see what it says. Wow, 171 over 113. What did I do? Who gives a crap? I knew that it read in at 120 earlier this morning. It goes up and down like water. I mean, this is ridiculous. But I want to sweat out toxins in my skin, in my body. So there's a lymph gland, and there's fascia, and there's all sorts of things going on in your body. And the lymph system has no pressure system, okay? So the only way to get rid of it is to get it to go back into this processing. It's processed right up in this area of the chest. Or go out your skin. Ideal way is to go out your skin. I got a little, I'll show you. This tent is really hot. And I got a zipper area here where it's 2 compartments. And I'm going to make that area over there the morning sauna. The ideal situation is I sit in a sauna every day for almost, this is going to be a healthy one, a lot healthier than an electric heated air sauna. This is just natural. But guess what? This is nylon. This whole tent's made out of nylon. So I'm sitting there getting plastic. How much plastic am I breathing? Really essential questions to do research on. So in a way, I would like to have a cloth tent. Can you repel water with cotton? I mean, it's wicking. It absorbs. I don't know. But I guess I could have a cloth tent on the inside and spray it. So somehow I need to work out this issue. This is a constant iterations of it, but I want to sweat out toxins every day, then go hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold. So if I was incredibly wealthy, to me, the sign of intelligence is wealth in the sense that you understand how to take care of yourself. I highly feel, I really totally believe that the sun is very good for you. Vitamin D, taking vitamin D is maybe, I calculated it, I need about 3 hours of sunlight daily. I don't believe that the sun is causing these cancers. It's my opinion. I don't believe that sun's causing you cancer. I believe it's 100% all these chemicals you're putting on your skin. Okay, so Merry Christmas. What's going to happen, I'm at the beach. So I can go over to the beach, lay in the sun on a couple of my towels. I used to sell these really cool towels. They got a strap on them that goes around. So I call them Thai style towels. They got a little strap that I can do it. You roll them up and then you tie it off so that it stays on. I'm going to try to sell these towels. I have my zipper pockets, zipper things. These are big enough to put your passport. If anybody wants to buy the towels or thing, I guess I'm going to sell the zipper pockets for $50. While I'm here in the United States, you can buy some. I don't know how many pairs I have. I have to keep about, I don't know, 5 packs around for me for the rest of my life. If you really want to stock up for the rest of your life, you need to buy about, I don't know, it's hard to say. A really smart person. See, a habit is something you need to have in every single piece of clothing I have has secret pockets in it. Why? Because it's a habit of using. It's a habit of using these secret pockets. I put my keys in them so I never lose them. I do it. Now, if you're fat, these things don't work very good, okay? And so if you want to be thin, you got to make it uncomfortable to be fat, okay? So this is part of the consequence theory of thing. But I want my pores to be open and plastics to not enter things. The word rayon, polyester, linen, all these words are words to say chemicals. Tattoos is, in my opinion, a type of insanity. Okay, it's insanity to put this many tattoos and put chemicals in your blood. Okay, I want no plastics or dyes to enter my skin. As much as I don't want any plastics and things, drinking out of a plastic bottle is bad for you. Okay, I don't know, a few years ago, Linda was telling me about, she was carrying a stainless steel bottle or porcelain or something. You got glass bottles and things. Stainless steel is probably the safest, okay? But you got, they had this big rush and everybody was getting rid of their plastic water bottles. Now they're all back to it, okay? Who's paying these guys off? Okay, but men, everybody, the men have three types of cancers, prostate, lung cancer, and colorectal cancer, which means colon cancer. So your butthole, your pit, your penis, and your lungs. So go figure, you're breathing in, which is causing lung cancer. It's excreting out through your skin. So it comes in on your skin and goes out through your prostate and thing. Go figure, it's just simple mechanical thing. These are the main types of cancers, okay? And it comes from, in my opinion, the skin. Okay, it's not everything that touches your skin enters your bloodstream and goes out your butthole or your penis. Okay, and so this causes prostate or colorectal. That's what a word. It's basically your asshole. Okay, causes polyps and other things because all these chemicals go in there and the body tries to protect you from these chemicals. So it goes in and encapsulates it. So every time you get a tattoo, there's all these little encapsulations of the tattoo. Richard sent me a real good thing on this video on what a tattoo does. Anybody that's putting any kind of chemical that kills germs on your body is killing your skin. Okay. You should have short underwear. You shouldn't have those boxer shorts because the least amount of skins. I have been wearing shorts for almost 25 years. Very good thing. I don't have any dyes entering my legs, right? I wore sandals most of the time, but I highly recommend that you got to be real careful on sandals because these flip-flops will derange your legs. I have a problem with my legs because of walking with flip-flops. But I also have a broken leg that's a little bit shorter, so I don't know. There's a little interesting band. When you have a pair of military pants, there's a little band on each side that adjusts so that it can pull in or pull out. This is the type of belt that you really want. I mean, if you have a leather belt, it's okay. But the truth is, we should be thin enough that we don't really need to wear a belt. I don't wear a belt, okay? I never wear a belt because it's just a pain in the butt, okay? But I try to make it so that my hips are thin enough that the pants can go on top of my hips and hang on my hips. There is an argument that comfort allows us to be fat. The more comfort we have, the more fat we are. Right now, I just realized I got a cot that my sister provided for me, and it's really very taut. I guess it's a Coleman cot or whatever. Really hard, okay? Don't think that hammocks or cots are comfortable. They're very, very hard, and they're kind of a temporary thing. This is not a good cot because you couldn't carry it with you. But it's good for the tent. And then I lay down on the cot, and then I put some... I started putting some padding on there. I put a sleeping bag on it. Then I put a comforter on. And then I was thinking, well, I can put a single bed in here. And I can put plastic underneath it. And then I go, wait a minute. What is happening with me being on the cot is I'm rolling over all the time. And that I want to roll over in the fetal position on the left side, on the right side, on the stomach. You want to be in all these positions because the body gets uncomfortable putting too much pressure on the outside. So one of the natural things about discomfort is you roll over. Okay, so you roll over. So I thought, nope, I'm going to keep it uncomfortable. I'd like to sleep on the ground, which is, I might do that, but the problem is, guess what? The bottom of this floor is plastic. So I need to get 100% cotton floor. I mean, we were talking about it. Forever chemicals are in the carpets, okay? I've been lucky. I've been sleeping in rooms with concrete floors with no paint on them for years, 26 years. So I'm healthy, okay? Anybody sleeping in a carpeted room's getting forever chemicals, toxins, entering their skins. You got mold entering your skins. And I haven't slept in gas-forced air furnaces or air conditioning for 26 years. Most of the time, I'm in a room that is just natural air on a concrete floor with a bed that's probably full of horrible crap, okay? But I carry a sheet, okay? I do carry a sheet, a king-size sheet anymore, so I can put over these beds. I have a king-size sheet over the top of my cot right now. But one question is, I don't know what bleach cotton is. Washing with soap is very dangerous for you. Not rinsing out the soap is the problem. Can you actually rinse? See, when something absorbs something, so when the soap goes in there, can you actually get the water, the soap to leave that cellular system? See, these are like cells. So I highly recommend that you use apple cider vinegar, maybe with your water, or baking soda or salt. And that was what you should use for soap. Okay, very complicated. The philosophy underwear. This is touching your skin. My shirt is 100% cotton. Maybe. Okay. You know, never trust anybody with a label. They will lie. People will lie to make money. That's the number. 99% of people feel zero remorse in lying to make money. 99%. I know very few people that won't lie. They will lie. Have you lied on your taxes? I mean, almost everybody lies in your taxes. I really have never lied to my taxes. I was laughing. I was in Walmart doing that checkout thing. I forgot this nutritional yeast, which is in plastic. God, everything's in plastic. Nutritional yeast is really good on vitamin B, and if you take a couple spoonfuls in the morning, you got a lot of energy. Nutritional yeast, you can buy it at Walmart. They got the expensive stuff or the cheap stuff. I almost always buy the cheap stuff because most of this marketing stuff is just extra money, right? You know the difference between a $55, you know, $100 hotel and a $15 hotel in most countries? $95. No, $85. $85. The difference between a $100 hotel and a $15 hotel is $85. That's what the difference is. So you're going to see me try to get rid of all the toxins in my body. I'm going to go completely organic. Wrong. I'm going to go completely free of chemicals. You guys, running with dark colored socks, long, you know, these elastic plastic sweatpants, these girls should not wear these. They should wear cotton clothing, okay? It's how you do anything is how you do everything. I'm Andy Lee Graham. I've been here. I'm here and you're not. Why not? I'm over 65 and I'm living in a tent and I'm going to continually get in touch with nature, okay? Because nature is one of the calming forces. And I'm going to soon do a video on my blood pressure. I'm definitely drinking too much coffee. Okay, I'm here and you're not. Why not? Become a Patreon. The value of being a Patreon is that it gives you the access to talk with me on things. I will go live on Sunday nights if anybody requests a topic, and on Zoom. I don't really have any use for anonymous people. I see it as just being a way to not be a man of your word or woman of your word. Anybody that avoids talking with other people is too scared to do anything. They're not really capable of taking on the world. Although I do think that there are certain things that should be anonymous. It's tough. We got to take the good from the bad, right? We can't, everything has good and bad in it, and that is perfection. Perfection is a little bit of good, a little bit of bad, but you want to have the majority of what a person, but if a person, if you hear a person white lie or do anything that's a lie, you got to understand they're not really a philosopher, they're a person. A clear and sustained effort to think clearly is a philosopher. To be a philosopher is easy. Everybody can be a philosopher. It's not, there's nothing. It's just that you do it. A lot of the Christians will fold in a second when everybody, I'm always laughing when they say there's a bunch of hypocrites in church. And I go, that's why they're there, guys, because they're trying to become a better person. It's a process. But the white lie, the hyperbole, the exaggeration is the signal that you need to know that they're not true. I mean, do you really hear Jordan Peterson or Thomas Sowell or maybe different people lying? If you hear somebody just blatantly lie, you have to, Nietzsche said that. He says, I'm not sad. I'm not really angry at you because you lied to me. I'm sad that I'm going to have to spend the rest of my life wondering if you're telling me the truth. Okay, so in a sense, if you're watching me and you're feeling I'm lying, you should stop watching, okay? If you feel that I'm telling you the truth, then you should continue to watch. It's heating up in this tent. I'm going to see if this area is, if the sun pig comes up, this area, this one box over here, which is facing the morning sun, will become up to 98. I'm waiting for my indoor-outdoor thermometer to come. I seem to have lost it. You know, these things break, whatever, right? But I'm going to have an indoor-outdoor thermometer. So as I'm living in this tent, I'm going to go in and out. Living in air conditioning is bad for you. Living in gas force. But living in a plastic tent's not too good for you either, right? So I bought a fan yesterday, and I'm going to create cross-flow ventilation and get the air moving through it. I got two fans. One, I'll put them in different locations, and I'll suck in air and blow out air at the same time, so there's constant flow of air, but of cooled air that's been in the shade. Okay, the difference between the shade and the sun is almost 110 degrees Fahrenheit at least. I'm trying to figure out whether I can put a plastic receptor for my indoor-outdoor thing in the direct sun. It probably melt according to where I put it. Okay, I'm Andy Lee Graham. Become a Patreon so you can have access to talk to me once in a while as a group. If you want to do private consulting, I can do that too. But how do I get paid? There's no way to get paid with all these trolls anymore because they'll literally do this stuff and then everybody gives refunds. It's amazing. Oh, there's such games being played right now.